This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part 4 of graphing trig functions, and we're going to continue with graphing trig functions in the form y equals a sine x. At the end of the last video, we came up with this. If we have something in the form y equals a sine x where a is greater than 0, then we found out the domain was always for the sine function is between negative infinity and infinity. The range was in between negative a and a. The period was 2 pi, and the amplitude was a, right? So this is when a was greater than 0. So now we're going to work a problem where a is not 0. I'm sorry, less than 0. So remember, we always want to remember this basic chart for y equals sine of x. The period is 2 pi. The amplitude is 1. And let's also write down that what the range is. The range was in between negative 1 and 1. So now let's try, instead of y equals sine x, let's do y equals negative sine x. So the question is, if I put in a value for x, what is if the y value if it's negative sine x? Well, in the second column here, we know what the values of sine x for these 5 values of x. So negative sine x would be, we just multiply all those numbers by negative 1. So 0 times negative 1 is 0. 1 times negative 1 is negative 1. 0 times negative 1 is 0 again. Negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1, and 0 times negative 1 is 0. All right, so our ordered pairs, remember, here's my x, here's my negative sine x, that's my y value here. I'm going to do this in red. So we've got the 0, 0. We've got pi over 2, negative 1. So it goes down, and then we have pi 0, same place as the other one. 3 pi over 2, positive 1. Oops, sorry. And 2 pi 0 right here. Now we could always fill in some more to get the idea. What's happening is this is going down first and then going up. It's actually a mirror image through the x-axis. So it's like if you flipped it and put everything that was above the x-axis below the x-axis. Everything that was below is now above the x-axis. So if I kept going, I can get 2 periods this way. All right, and remember this keeps going, so you might want to put a little arrow at the end. I've graphed 2 periods. Now, what is the period is still going to be 2 pi, correct? We still have a period of 2 pi. And what's the amplitude here? All right, well, it's still an amplitude of 1, right? Remember, it's half the distance from the minimum to the maximum point. So it still has an amplitude of 1. And the range, what's the range? It still goes in between negative 1 and 1. So it's pretty similar to y equals sine of x, except one thing. It's flipped. It goes down first. Now remember, you can always just plug in your own values and get enough ordered pairs to do this if you forget what the values for sine of x is. I just did this the quick way, but remember, you could put in pi over 2 in for x into y equals negative sine x, compute it all over again, say that's negative the sine of pi over 2, so it's negative 1, and get your answer of negative 1. So here we have the graph of y equals negative sine x. Let's try another one. All right, how about y equals negative 3 sine x? Okay, so I know what the values for the sine of x, but I need to know the values for negative 3 times the sine of x. So go ahead and fill in these ordered pairs on your own, and then graph those ordered pairs over here and see if you can get a picture. Put the video on pause in order to do this, and then state the period, the amplitude, and the range. Okay, Hopefully you're back with me. All right, so each value of sine of x gets multiplied by negative 3. So 0 times negative, so negative 3 times 0, negative 3 times 1, negative 3 times 0, negative 3 times negative 1, and negative 3 times 0. I've got these five ordered pairs, 0, 0 right here. Pi over t, negative 3. All right, so it goes down. Now, why would it go down first? Because of that minus sign here. And it's also stretched. Instead of just going down one space, the 3 means it went all the way down here. So let's keep going. Pi 0, we're back up here. 3 pi over t, 3. That'll be way up here. And then 2 pi, 0. And so hopefully you notice what happens. This goes down first, but it also gets stretched up. In other words, the last video I think we did y equals, this goes up. We did y equals 3 sine x. It went up first, but it was stretched up and went down. Back, let's look back at that one. So this was in our last video. In red, we did y equals 3 sine x. Notice it got stretched up. It started all the way up here at 3, right? I mean, it started at 0, 0, and then it went to pi over 2 all the way up to 3. And then one we just did goes down first. So let's see. The period is still 2 pi. What's the amplitude? Well, the amplitude is 3. Now, remember the amplitude is a distance, so it's a positive number. So it wasn't negative 3. It ends up being the absolute value of that number. And the range was in between negative 3 and positive 3, right? The very lowest point was negative 3. The very highest point was 3. Remember, the range is the y values. All right, so let's see if we can make a prediction here. In the last video, we did problems where a was positive, and we got that the domain was between negative infinity to infinity, the range was in between negative a and a, and the period was 2 pi, and the amplitude was a. All right, let's see if we could do it where a is a negative number. Okay, remember the domain's always the same for the sine. It's always any number. But this is going to be a little bit tricky to write the range. Remember, a is a negative number. So if a was a negative number and you did this, that would be negative a was a positive number, right? And you would have a positive number before a negative number, and that's not how you write things. So it's a little bit tricky here. You have to put the smallest number first, and that would be a. A is negative, right? And then if I put negative a, it would be a positive number. Okay, so we could write it like that. Okay. Period's still 2 pi. And the amplitude, all right, was a positive number. So a is a negative number. Oops, sorry. I don't know why this does this on me. So we have to make sure it's positive. I put absolute value. So the question is, could we combine this into one thing that makes sense so we don't have to separate the negatives and the positives? And yes, we can. So here we go. Y equals a sine x. And it doesn't matter whether a is positive or negative. Let's see if we could do it. The domain is always going to be negative infinity to infinity. The range is going to be trickier if I want to use these variables. We've got to make sure it's always a negative number on the left and a positive number on the right. One way of doing that is using absolute value. So if I put the absolute value of a and then a minus sign in front of it, then I'm writing a negative number, right? Because the absolute value of a will be positive, and that goes to just the positive number. So if I had to write this out, unfortunately, it's a little more confusing. That's how I could express both of these into one. All right, now how about the period? The period in either case was 2 pi, right? And how about the amplitude? Well, we just made sure it was positive, so we could use the absolute value of a. So putting it all together, if you wanted to use variables, this is how you could do it. But let's go ahead and just do it for a problem. It's much easier to write it without using all these absolute values, etc. Alright, so let's say we wanted to graph y equals negative 1/3 x and state what the domain, range, period, and amplitude are. Alright, why don't you put the video on pause and try this all on your own first, and then take it off pause. Alright, domain. Always the same for the sine function, negative infinity to infinity. Now what's the range going to be? Well, see this negative 1/3? That means it's going to go down, starting at negative 1/3, that's going to be the bottom point, and that'll be our top point. Period. Always the same for something in this form. And what's the amplitude? What's the height going to be? 1/3. And it says graph two cycles. So we have a period of 2 pi, so let's go ahead and just make our markings up to 2 pi on both sides. That's one way I like to do it. We're only going to go up 1/3. You don't have to, you know, make your y-axis in terms of when. You could just call this 1/3. That's fine. And then that would be, of course, negative 1/3. Make it convenient for yourself. So let's graph it. We're going to have 0, 0. Now, the question is, do we go up or down first? This minus sign means we go down first. So we're going down here, then back through here, up to 1/3, and then down. You could also make a chart of values. Sorry, here we go. Two cycles means two periods. So we have... And just put a little arrow at the end to show, you know, it does keep going on forever and ever. So what we have is two cycles of y equals negative 1/3 x. If you were to put the ordered pairs down, it's not too bad. So remember doing y equals negative 1/3 sine x, which you have to remember are these values. Remember, it goes 0, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, 2 pi, and the values were 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 0. Remember that. So if you're going to do negative 1/3 x, remember the y values get multiplied by negative 1/3. So we still have these x values. But all the y values get multiplied by negative 3. So that's 0, 1 times, I'm sorry, by negative 1/3. 1 times negative 1/3, there's your negative 1/3. This is 0. This ends up being positive 1/3 and 0. And those are the order pairs I have here. 0, pi over 2, negative 1/3, pi 0, 3 pi over 2, 1/3, and 2 pi. All right, so I think we've got this situation hopefully under control. And to summarize, we now have graphed y equals a sine of x. And if we were going to just use the letter a, we would have to sort of write it like this to express what the domain, range, period, and amplitude is. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.